Welcome to Invest. We talk about investing, finance, and professional development. So, current time of 10:05 a.m. on Eastern Time on the first day of August today. Ethereum contract $1,677, down about 0.06% so far. Respect over crypto market and equity market on this Monday morning so far is relatively flat. As on the future perspective, as we what we talked about last night. Was depicting a relatively down to flat day today, so it makes sense across the board. And on the media affectation front, I would say there isn't anything specific. Seems like, you know, most of the catalysts are just going to be percolating up until, you know, obviously on August 10th, which is the upcoming CPI report, which would depict the inflationary pressure and the recessionary environment that we're in. And some other corporate earnings calls that we will be experiencing as well to see, you know, how will this triangulate into the volatility going forward, right? And before I dive into the technicals, I heard some really terrible news this morning. So one of my partner, Gary Rubinoff, he passed away this past week. And I feel extremely frustrated and disappointed in myself that I found out so late. And, you know, just to give you guys like who Gary is, let me show you. So Gary is one of my partners at Tings Capital. And as of Monday, just let me just shift my face so you could see it. Last Monday, July 25th, he passed away at his home, and he left the world at the age of 61 only. Now, you know, he has a wife and he has two sons, and the wife, I know she's currently studying in school right now to pursue, you know, to become a psychologist. So with Gary's sudden departure, I have spoken with the family, and I guess like this is part of me giving, you know, back, you know, because Gary has always been like a father figure to me, you know, in helping me establish Tings Capital, to, you know, because he's a legend in the venture capital space. And he's always been a dear friend and one of the kindest people that I've ever known, right? So I promised the, you know, the wife, you know, her his wife Dee Dee, and the family that I'll take care of them, you know. And I, you know, obviously, you know, I'm still, you know, I have a family to take care of as well, right? So something that I want to be doing going forward is to establish some sort of a funding source to be supporting their family going forward. And the, you know, and I don't mean this to be a plug, right? You know, but on the Patreon income that I'll be getting going forward, you know, I'll be giving them the money to be supporting their, you know, just their rent, you know, their, you know, two of their, you know, both of their sons are going to college right now. One is going to Williams College and the other one is on the verge of going to college. So that's more expenditure going forward, right? And Dee Dee, she's obviously not working at the moment. So I need to be supportive of their family. Yeah, this is crushing to me. It's definitely, you know, something that I'm not saying I saw this coming, because like Gary has been, you know, not doing the best health wise, and you know, he's been quite shaky, you know, and he's also traveling a lot, so yeah, I don't know. It's gonna be a big financial burden on me, so, and for me, you know, as the leader, I need to be. To be the North Star, I need to be motivating the team and supporting the team. And you know, when my partners leave, the you know, the Earth, you know, I need to be stepping up to support their family because it's a lifelong partnership, it's a lifelong family. So yeah, if there's any ways that you guys can support me, I would appreciate it. On Patreon or anyways, any sort of, in additional income for me would be appreciated. So anyways, let's just dive into technical. Sorry for, I wasn't planning on posting, but like, it's important that I, give Gary the recognition, right? And with respect to recording time of let's just see, 10:11 a.m. on the Eastern Time, across the media application front is relatively flat, right? We are going to be expecting some corporate earnings call here and there, but with respect to the major one that's coming, that's going to be the upcoming CPI report that's coming out on August 10th, which will depict the story on what happened in July, right? And across the spectrum right now, again, right, on a daily, for Ethereum, we are relatively down, right, in terms of the technical. We're quite depressed, right? We've crossed up for quite some time, and we are looking for some sort of a level to come down, right? We have been getting resisted at 66 out of 70 for quite some time. So seeing a level leap down as we crack below the 1650 all the way to 1550, and ideally to see more of a level down to 1250 is very possible in the near term, right? But on a weekly, you could see that clearly we're crossing up, right? And on a monthly, you've been plateauing for quite some time. So again, right, daily looks negative, right? Which means that we should see some negative volatility coming in a couple of days. But on the weeks and months out, it's quite bullish from here. Okay. And then on Bitcoin as well, just covering this as well, you can see that we've dragged up for quite some time, and we have been getting rejected at 60 out of 70 for quite some time, right? So seeing some cool down, and I'm not saying a significant one, maybe coming down to just a hair below above 20,000, will be very logical across the spectrum, right? As you cross down, you cross up, and you should allow for more of a escalating staircase from here, right? And then for Classic, it's quite extended, so you should see some normalization coming at the 70 out of 70. So it should come down all the way to 25, which will be surprised from there. And Dogecoin and all the other smaller coins are all trading on the negative daily perspective, but weeks and months out are quite bullish from here. Okay. So I wasn't planning on doing this, but I cannot believe that I missed Gary's departure, and I was working, right? I remember I was on the West Coast that day, and I feel like extremely disappointed that I heard about Gary's departure from my lawyer, right? And I felt like I should have been there for him. Yeah, now I just have a additional financial burden on me to be supporting him and his family. So yeah, feel free, if you find my work helpful, please, subscribe to my Patreon, and I will send the money to the family. And obviously I am supporting them and my family and my well-being as well. So it's a lot to juggle, right? But I appreciate you for hopping on this call with me on this Monday. And let's, stay positive, right? Life is really short. Gary was only 61. So yeah, have a good day and take care.